project for a mobile device where you have sort of the dance in the palm of your hand, and you can take it anywhere and share it with anyone, anytime. How that has influenced Richard's work, and I'd like to hear also from the dancers any comments they have about their experience with this project.
We're playing with Fellini characters, you know, and so it was more like a film, trying to think of how to do it, of moments of the 50s, and the research was wonderful, and then you asked me to be 150 to 80 pounds, and so it was really lovely and juicy to jump on something like that.
What I love about it is this sparseness of it, and the long phrases, and the breath, and there's a hundred ways you can do that. And it reminded me of the jazz singers when I heard Joe Williams and Sarah Vaughan in their later life, when they would sing a song. It was, when they were young, it was always on beat. And then as they got older, the beat kept on, but they just sailed. And they held that. And they ended there or wherever. And it became a kind of more conversational. For me, it's a mystery. I could still do it every day and still see something different.
Then he said you're going to be jumping the whole time. And I said, for how long? My son today, my 9-year-old, said, it's just 2 minutes. Okay. And so I was thinking about him a little bit by the time I got down to this corner. My 10-year-old son, so that's what inspired it. But it's movie music. There's something about it. Richard also imagined that this one would be filmed outdoors, and you told me that the first second that we started working on it. So I've always imagined, no matter what studio we worked in, that I was outside somewhere.
I think it was different for me working with Richard, because he conceived it as sort of a miniature. I didn't ask him why he had decided that this was me, but I thought afterward that maybe it was because he had seen me do a solo in which I talked to my dad. And the interesting thing for me was to think about these 2 minutes, Gertrude Stein and Alice B. Toklas, who I had a different picture of, and Gertrude indulging in these little baby talk, the letters to him and which were responded, and the love of those things against each other, the mischief and the fun.
When I first started, he said, I envisioned with this music that you like smoke. Wafted, you know, like that it actually one has to find a way to hopefully with the person who's choreographed to find what fits that persona, that movement.
I'm wondering if anyone has any comments or questions for Richard or any of the dancers.
I like seeing the whole picture. So with your piece in particular, I was surprised at the intimacy.
The video camera was really helpful, because then it became unlimited ways that I could watch it. And I was also looking at it in terms of how did it look on the camera, which gave me information to go back in the studio and make changes based on that.
After every rehearsal, I got home and there it was on my computer, what we'd done, in a little tiny box.
I always used the video camera in rehearsal, and I always enjoyed what I got. And even after we would fully mount something and videotape it and professionally edit, I always found there was something on those rehearsal tapes that still was not there. I also love seeing the single performer in the camera.
It's an inspiration for younger dancers, I think, and I think also the music choices were wonderful.
Thank you so much.